Hello children, and welcome all of you to the class of mathematics. We are learning finding the roots of quadratic equation by formula method from chapter number 4, quadratic equations. In the previous video lesson, we solved question number 2 of exercise 4.3. Today we are going to begin with question number 3 of exercise 4.3. So here is the question. Find the roots of following equations. First equation is 1 minus 1 upon x is equal to 3, where we are given the condition that x is not equal to 0. Now to find the roots of this equation, first we need to check out whether it is a quadratic equation. Otherwise, how will we solve the equation then? So for that, what will we do? We will cross multiply and try to compare the equation with the standard form of quadratic equation. So when you cross multiply, you can write it like this: x into x minus 1 upon x is equal to 3. Take this x to the right side, so we get x square minus 1 upon x is equal to 3. Taking x to right side, we get x square minus 1 is equal to 3. Still we will try to write this in proper form. So we get x square minus 3x minus 1 is equal to 0, and this is a quadratic equation. Now the question is, we need to find the roots of this quadratic equation. So for that, what do we do? We will first compare this equation with the standard form, and then we will write the values of a, b and c. So here a is 1, b is equal to minus 3, and c is minus 1. Now since exercise 4.3 is based on solving the quadratic equation by formula method, so we are using the formula to find the roots of this quadratic equation. So since we have written values of a, b and c, now let's find out the value of the discriminant. So d is equal to b square minus 4ac is our discriminant. Now we all have the values of a, b and c. Let's substitute that. B square is minus 3 the whole square minus 4 into 1 into minus 1. Minus 3 square is 9. Minus minus will get plus. So this is 9 plus 4, and 9 plus 4 is 13. That is the value of discriminant. Now the roots of the quadratic equation is given by the formula x is equal to minus b plus minus square root d upon 2a. Let us substitute the values of a, b and capital D there. So we get x is equal to minus of minus 3, because b is minus 3. So minus of minus 3 plus minus, and value of d is 13. So it is square root 13 upon 2 into 1. Now this minus minus will become plus. So we get 3 plus minus root 13 upon 2. So how many roots this quadratic equation has? It has 2 roots. X is equal to 3 plus square root 13 upon 2, or x is equal to 3 minus square root 13 upon 2. Alright. So whenever you are asked to find the roots of given equation, you just simplify it first, write it in the standard form, and then solve for it. If the method is not specified, you can solve it by factorization method, or you can solve it by the formula method. Choice is all yours. Alright, let us move to the next sum. So this is the second sum from question number 3. 1 upon x plus 4 minus 1 upon x minus 7 is equal to 11 upon 30, where x is not equal to minus 4 and 7. It is given to us because the moment x is minus 4 or x is equal to 7, the denominator becomes 0, and when the denominator is 0, there is no meaning to the term then. All right. Now see, looking at the equation, we can't make out whether it is a quadratic equation or it is a linear equation or whatever. So it's your choice. What do? We can just cross multiply and check out what equation we get. So when you cross multiply, it is 1 into x minus 7 minus 1 into x plus 4 upon x plus 4 into x minus 7 is equal to 11 upon 30. So we will write it like this. This is by cross multiplying the terms. Now to solve this, what we will do in the numerator, we will first take out the brackets and write the terms. So x minus 7 minus x, this minus plus will become minus, so minus 4 upon x plus 4 in one bracket, x minus 7 in other bracket is equal to 11 upon 30. Alright, so here this plus x minus x we can cancel, so we are left with minus 11 upon x plus 4 in one bracket and x minus 7 in other bracket is equal to 11 upon 30. And whenever there is equal to sign between the two terms, we can directly cancel this 11. So we are left with minus 1 upon x plus 4 x minus 7 is equal to 1 upon 30. And when you cross multiply this, what you get is minus 30 is equal to x plus 4 in one bracket and x minus 7 in other bracket. Let's multiply both the brackets and just check out what do we get. So when you multiply x into the first bracket plus 4 into the bracket again, the same bracket again, is equal to minus 30. So we get x square minus 7x plus 4x minus 28 is equal to minus 30. So again we can simplify this. X square minus 3x minus 28 is equal to minus 30. We can shift this 28 to right side. So we get x square minus 3x. When you shift this 28 to right side, it will become minus 2. And again taking minus 2 to the left side, it will give us plus 2 is equal to 0, which is a perfect quadratic equation. Now we can solve it by formula method. So for that, let's compare this with the standard form and we get the value of a as 1, b is equal to minus 3 and c is equal to 2. So discriminant d is b square minus 4ac, and let us substitute the value. Minus 3 the whole square minus 4 into 1 into 2. So we get 9 minus 8 and 9 minus 8 is 1. So value of d is 1. Alright, now let's use the formula to find the roots. And for that, our formula is x is equal to minus b plus minus square root d upon 2a. Alright, we got the value of d as 1 and we have the value of a, b, c like this. Let us substitute the values now. So x is equal to minus of minus 3 plus minus d is 1, so square root 1, and square root 1 is 1 children. 2 into 1 will be 2. So we are left with x is equal to minus of minus 3 plus minus 1 upon 2. Its meaning is x is equal to 3 plus 1 upon 2, that is 4 upon 2, and 4 upon 2 is 2, or x is equal to 3 minus 1 upon 2, which will be equal to 2 upon 2, and that is x. So we have got two roots for the given equation. And which are the two roots? The two roots are x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 1 are the roots of the given equation. Alright, so this is all about exercise 4.3, question number 3. And from question number 4 till the last question, everything is omitted as I told you in the previous video lesson. So here we completed exercise 4.3. But I have some questions for you children. These are all the questions which have already come in the previous year's examination. And let's try solving it. This is considered to be the hot question. Just see, we have to solve it for the value of x. Meaning is that you have to find the value of x. What is given to you? X square minus 2 in the bracket a square plus b square into x plus a square minus b square the whole square is equal to 0. Now, if you compare this with the standard form, you will realize that this is a quadratic equation because it is exactly similar to ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Let's find out what is the value of a, b and c here. So we get a is equal to 1. We get b is equal to, look at this, this is what is the value of b, b into x. So we get b is equal to minus 2 in the bracket a square plus b square, and value of c is the constant term, that is a square minus b square the whole square. We got the values of a, b and c. So what next? Next is finding the discriminant, which is b square minus 4ac. So let's start substituting the values. We have b square is minus 2 in the bracket a square plus b square the whole square, this is b square, minus 4 into 1 into c is a square minus b square the whole square. Alright, now this minus 2 the whole square will be plus 4. If I solve it, I get plus 4, and then a square plus b square the whole square will remain as it is, minus the other term, if you see, minus 4 I have written as it is, and next term is a square minus b square the whole square. This is how we can write. Now in both the terms 4 is common, so I can take out 4 common. So if you take 4 common in the bracket, what do we have? We have a square plus b square the whole square minus a square minus b square the whole square. Just go stepwise, children. You will never go wrong if you go stepwise. The sum looks little complicated, but actually it is not. Slowly, stepwise you go, it will never go wrong. Okay, so we have written up till this 4 in the bracket a square plus b square the whole square minus a square minus b square the whole square. Now if you see the terms, this looks like a square minus b square. Can you make out that? So we can make use of the identity a square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b in one bracket and a minus b in the other bracket, and solve this. So we have this as our equation which we got. Let's make use of the formula a square minus b square. So we will write it like this. First we will write 4, then in the bracket this is a plus b, so a square plus b square plus a square minus b square in one bracket, and a minus b in the other bracket, so a square plus b square minus a square, and minus minus will become plus, so plus b square. Now just check out what you can cancel. We can cancel b square from the first bracket and a square from the second bracket, so we are left with 4 in the bracket 2a square in the other bracket 2b square, and multiply all, what do you get? It is 16a square b square, that is the value of discriminant d. Once we get the value of d, now making use of the formula, so our formula is x is equal to minus b plus minus root d upon 2a. So let's make use of this formula to solve it further. This is what is our formula, and we have calculated the value of a, b and c. We'll write it like this, and now let's substitute the values. So we get minus b, so minus sign as it is, and what is the value of b? It is minus 2 in the bracket a square plus b square, so that's minus b plus minus square root d. Value of d we have calculated as 16a square b square, so we have written it like that, upon 2 into a is 1. Alright, so let's solve this. Now this minus minus will be plus, so we get 2 in the bracket a square plus b square plus minus, and square root 16 is 4, square root a square b square is ab, so we get 4ab upon. Clear? Okay. Now we can take 2 common. So x is equal to, when you take 2 common outside the bracket, we get a square plus b square plus minus 2ab upon 2. So we can cancel this 2. And so what are we left with? We're left with x is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. This is one value. And x is equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab. This is other value. So we got two values of x. We can also write it like this, a plus b the whole square or a minus b the whole square. All right. So this is what is the sum. This may come for say 5 marks or 4 marks. And an important sum. I want all of you to solve this in the notebook without looking into the solution which I have given here. You just write down the sum and try to solve it on your own. All right? Okay. Let's see the other sum. This is also a simple sum. Just by looking at the equation, you feel like it's very difficult, but it is actually not. Here also we have to find the value of x. So some children may bounce to solve it by formula method, which will go very lengthy. So what you will do here? Very simple. You will just open up the bracket and write all the terms first. So 12 a b x square minus 9 a square x minus minus will be plus 8 b square x minus 6ab is equal to 0. Alright. Now from the first two terms, we'll take 3ax common. So 3ax in the bracket, 4bx minus 3a plus from the next two term, we'll take 2b common. So 4bx minus 3b is equal to 0. So what do we get? We get 4bx minus 3a in one bracket and 3ax plus 2b in other bracket is equal to 0. And what does this mean? This is 4bx minus 3a is equal to 0 or 3ax plus 2b is equal to 0. Now we can easily find out the value of x. So we get x is equal to 3a upon 4b or we get the value of x as minus 2b upon 3a. So though you feel like the equation looks difficult, but actually if you give a little time to understand what is to be done with the equation, it's very easy to solve. Alright, so this is another important different type of equation. Now along with this, there are some questions given to you children as an assignment. I want all of you to please solve this, and wherever required, I have given you answers so that you can tally your answers. Some of the questions are hot questions also. So the last question here is little, it will take little time for you to solve. Please check your answer after solving and practice the sums. All right. So we will stop for today and see you all in the next video lesson. Until then, bye and take care.